Good evening, everybody. How are you? I'd like to welcome you to Bay Path College. My name's Brianna Sittler. I am the Director of Special Programs, which means I create the Kaleidoscope brochure, which is in the front. Tonight's event is our kickoff for the season for the spring. I have a lot of music this season. I wanted to let you know a couple important details. If you have a cell phone, please put it on silent or vibe for us. If you're looking for restrooms, through the doors, down the stairs, and to the back corner on the right. If you need an elevator, it's out this door to the other side by the entry in the back. If you're a student and you're here for a professor's credit, please sign in. I want to say that the Kaleidoscope series is made possible by Bay Path College and People's Bank. And with that, I would like to welcome you to hear a little bit about Long Meadow Chamber Music Society.
Thank you, Brianna. Can everybody hear me? I guess. I recognize a lot of our Long Meadow Chamber patrons, but are there any people who are not Long Meadow Chamber patrons here for the first time? That's great. I'm really, really happy. So we've been, Long Meadow Chamber has been in Long Meadow for 30 years. We provide three concerts a year. Most of them have been at the First Church in Long Meadow, but we're expanding out and been in different venues. Our mission is to provide chamber music for the people of the Pioneer Valley, performed by Pioneer Valley musicians. And most of these musicians are either Springfield Symphony musicians or on the five college faculty. Three of the musicians live here in Long Meadow, my wife Marcia, Joel Pishon, and his wife Volsi all live actually right across Bliss Park from us. So everything is very, very local. I would like to thank Brianna and the Kaleidoscope series. I hope you pick up one of their brochures because again, the Kaleidoscope series is a fantastic asset for this community. And not only do they provide all sorts of cultural enrichment here, but we're the first musical event of this year, but as you'll notice, Kevin Rhodes is coming. Was it three times, Brianna? Next week he's coming and he will be here with the performer who's doing the Mendelssohn Violin Concerto next weekend. And I mean, I think this is really a fantastic opportunity for everybody here to participate and tell your friends, because I think it's really a wonderful opportunity for everybody in Long Meadow to, we're all enriched by this series that Brianna and Bay Path have put on. And we're honored as our Chamber Music Society to be participating in it. So, thank you very much. I'm one of the co-directors, and we perform many functions as co-directors, one of which is kind of stage management, which we do. But I also want to introduce my other co-director who is here tonight in the name of Margot Rowland. Are you there? Come on out and take a bow, because Margot has the duty tonight of being a page turner, which is not something you want to just kind of undertake lightly. It's very stressful, actually, especially when you just come from Boston to do it. So I want to introduce Margot and her husband, Tom, as another one of our co-directors. He's in Boston tonight, but Margot will be page turning. So as co-directors, we perform multiple duties, and this is one of them. So I think without further ado, our next concert is sometime in April, and it's on the program there. It's going to feature Mike Sussman, who's our principal clarinet in the Springfield Symphony. And it's going to be an all-American program with Gershwin, and it should be really fun. And I think that will be back over at the First Church. So without any further ado, I think I'll introduce the musicians, or they can come out. And are you there, musicians? I think some of them are probably back there. Okay, enjoy the concert. Oh, I have to turn the lights on, too, just a second.
take yourself back to 1914, when this piece was written, and if you could think just for a moment about the remarkable creativity that was going on in the world in those pre-war years. In Paris, we had the beginnings of Cubism, fantastic developments in Impressionism. In Germany, we had the move from Chromaticism to atonality. In fact, Schoenberg's Pierrot Lunaire was debuted in 1913, and so was Stravinsky's Rite of Spring in Paris in 1913. It was an amazingly prolific and highly artistic time. Ravel was writing music that was very much in the French tradition of Debussy, which means that they were looking to other sounds, that is to say, what we now call world music. Pentatonic scales, whole tone scales, something you might think about in the very first movement. The simple division in four, which classical music has always had, we've always divided it one and two and three and four. Ravel takes that and divides it one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Instead of one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, it becomes one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Simple little things like that change the way people began to think and feel about music.
Thank you. Think of this as probably the most romantic piano quintet ever written. It's you can think of it as a cross between Wagner and Verdi, even though it's French. It's and part of the romanticism may be due to the fact that he was in love with one of his students at the time, and the story goes that Saint-Saëns played the premiere, and recognizing that it was dedicated to this student, which Saint-Saëns also happened to be in love with, proclaimed it a piece of rubbish afterwards and walked off stage. But nevertheless, it is an ultra passionate piece of music with great highs and lows and lots of drama. And once in a while, you can get kind of inklings, it was written in the late 1870s, of impressionism to come. And there's some very delicate, beautiful passages, especially in slow movement. So we hope you enjoy it. We hope our instruments stay in tune.
Thank you. you.